I hope y'all are having a great day. It's been a while, I know. I've been kind of busy with my dual credit classes, but I have time now. So I'm going to be reviewing The Moon and More by Sarah Dessen. I'm a really big fan of Sarah Dessen. I think I've read all of her books with the exceptions of That Summer and Keeping the Moon, which I do plan to read someday. I just really love her books. A lot of people critique her and say that her books are too calculated or follow a certain formula, which I guess I can definitely understand that, but The Moon and More is kind of different. She breaks the mold a little bit. Anyway, I'm just a big fan of Sarah Dessen. I think this is her 11th book, and I'll probably read all of the books that she comes out with. This is her latest one, and if you don't know, it's about a girl named Emmeline. She's 18 years old. She is about to go off to college, and she lives in a beach town called Colby, which is the setting that most of Dessen's books are set in. She has a boyfriend named Luke, who is basically the perfect boyfriend because he's handsome and funny and sweet, and they've been together since freshman year. Enter a new boy named Theo. He's a tourist from New York City working on a film project, and he is supposedly sophisticated and exciting, and best of all, he thinks Emmeline is much too smart for Colby. Emmeline's a smart girl. She got into Columbia. Basically, this book is about Emmeline's decision to stay with her roots in Colby or go out and explore something beyond this small beach town that she's known all her life. I'm gonna put the book down. I don't know why reviewers hold the book up throughout the whole video. It just seems tiring. Less effort, happier me. First, let's talk about Emmeline, our protagonist. I really liked her. I found her very nice and hardworking, even when it wasn't required of her. She was very caring too, even though she sometimes wouldn't show it all too well. And although she's smart on paper, after all, she did get into an Ivy League, I felt like her thoughts and her actions didn't really add up to that level of intelligence. But I digress. She and Luke have been together since freshman year, and basically in Colby, in such a small town, that's the paved road to marriage. Luke is a nice guy, I guess. He's funny, he's sweet, but then he does something really bad, and it's pretty inexcusable because it does end up in the splitting of the couple. But I couldn't help but feel like it was just a plot device to make room for the new boy, Theo. Because if we're being honest, these two have been together since freshman year, and now they're about to go off to college together. It just seemed way too convenient of a time for Luke to do what he did. But whatever, moving on to Theo, the new boy. He's from New York and he's working on a film project and he thinks he's better than everyone. Obviously, you can probably tell that I did not enjoy his character. Dessen purposely writes an unlikable love interest in Theo. He's always this far away from being charming. He has this nice, nerdy boy appeal, but no matter what progress he makes, he always does something to erase that. He was infuriating because he had this way of suggesting things that would make it sound like, oh, it's definitely up to you, but really it was like, oh, if you don't choose the same option as me, you are unclassy, from a small town, and not worth my time. He had this mindset that he was better than everyone and that Colby was inferior for some reason because it was a small town and he was from NYC. And this is one of the ways that Dessen breaks out of her usual formula, because none of the love interests are particularly swoon-worthy. And I was okay with that. Emmeline is a strong, independent girl, which I really liked. One thing that I especially adored about her was that after she and Luke split up, obviously she was sad, I mean, it was a super long relationship, but she doesn't turn into a bitter ex-girlfriend. She just acts normally. She doesn't think malicious thoughts. She doesn't completely cut Luke out of her life. She just acts normally, and it is so refreshing to see. As usual, in a Dessen novel, there are family issues. Emmeline lives with her mother and her stepfather, as well as two stepsisters. Instead, Dessen focuses on Emmeline's relationship with her half-brother, Benji, and her real father. It was like the other family members were sacrificed for the focus on Benji. But regardless, I did enjoy that aspect of it. I felt like Emmeline and Benji, they could have bonded more, but I liked what Dessen showed. The plot is pretty slow moving in this novel, and for someone who's not used to that kind of thing, it might be a burden. All in all, I thought The Moon and More was a very, very good read. It's definitely not Dessen's best, because I think my heart will always be reserved for The Truth About Forever, but The Moon and More was a fun read. I think a lot of my enjoyment came out of the main character, Emmeline. She had this honest, genuine realness about her, which I really enjoyed. All in all, I would recommend The Moon and More to Dessen fans, contemporary fans, or people looking for a light beach read. If you like this review, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, click subscribe, or maybe check out my blog. I do have a written review posted on there. It's quite lengthy, but a lot more coherent. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day and happy reading. Bye.